like to welcome everybody into the gallery today for this really exciting exhibition. Xiaoping came to Australia as a 29-year-old. I'm not sure that he had any idea about the journey that he was going to go on, but it was a very exciting journey, and he decided that he wanted to understand this country, and so he travelled, and in his travels he sought out communities in the north of Australia and met and became incredibly good friends with a number of significant Aboriginal artists, including the late Jimmy Pike and the late Johnny Bullen. The friendship was one that evolved not only out of their creative talents, their cross-cultural identities and culture, but it was an emotional bond of friendship. Out of these associations together, whether it was sleeping under the stars, living off the land, sitting back to back, drawing, crushing, watching Johnny Bullenbullen crush the ochres for his paint, so reminiscent of the types of things that Xiaoping was trained to do in his country of birth. All of these things have been an emotional journey for Xiaoping, and the paintings that you see today are more than the way they present on the canvas. They are emotional journeys of great significance that have been a cultural evolution for Xiaoping. So please feel free to have a chat with him. Without any further ado, can I please introduce the minister, who was a great speaker. I was listening to him last night in Canberra at the opening of the celebration of the National Portrait Gallery's 20 years. He does a very good job. So,
thank you. Thank you, Lorraine, and if I could also acknowledge the traditional owners of the land on which we gather. It is important that we take the time to pause and reflect about those who have trod this ground before us and those who will do so after us. Lorraine, thank you so much for the invitation to be here tonight. Something I've learned about Lorraine is that when she asks you to do something, you shouldn't treat it as a request, you should treat it as an order. And just say yes, because it will save time. Lorraine, you've created something wonderful here. You make an enormous contribution to the nation's artistic life, and I was with Lorraine last night at the 20th anniversary celebration of the National Portrait Gallery in Canberra. And as I was sitting there, I was thinking that our great national collecting institutions, the National Portrait Gallery, the National Gallery, to name but a few, while they're really important as repositories of some of our great national works and our history, it is actually the commercial galleries and artists who are the beating heart and the lifeblood of the arts in Australia. While we all, I'm sure, agree and recognise the innate virtue of the creative process, and we all believe in art for art's sake, there's nothing inconsistent between that and recognising the contribution that the arts make to our economy, the fact that the arts are the livelihood of so many people, and also that the arts have that capacity to be a transmission. Commercial arts can be one of the important ways that works are transmitted through our community more broadly. So I think those two things can sit and do sit very happily together. But we are here today to mark something really important with this exhibition. The exhibition, the works of Xiaoping. And can I acknowledge that you've done something pretty amazing for an artist, that you have immersed yourself with Australia's Indigenous communities, particularly in the Kimberley, particularly in Arnhem Land. And because of that immersion, you have earned the respect of artists. And that respect has enabled you to take part in a creative and an artistic dialogue with some of our great Indigenous artists and great Indigenous painters. And I think that that immersion, that respect and that dialogue that has enabled is here for us to see on the walls today. So can I acknowledge the deep commitment that you have to Indigenous Australians, the respect you've shown them, and that they have influenced you and you have influenced them. We were talking earlier about that wrestle that an artist has with their works, the ones that you hold on to and the ones that you make available to find another home. That can't be something that's easy, but as you said, you can have some works that are important to you. You can have some other works that stay on your walls, but unless they're available or others are available to be enjoyed and appreciated by a broader community, then you're not fulfilling all that your talent can provide to all of us. So thank you for what you've done. Lauraine, thank you for having us all here today, and it gives me great pleasure to officially declare the exhibition open. Thank you.